Hello students, this video will be a very short description on an important effect in the physiology, the incretin effect. So what is this incretin effect and what are the incretins? First of all, incretin can be broken up simply as incremental insulin secretion. So, you know, if you give oral glucose and if IV glucose is given, both are going to cause insulin secretion. Naturally, there will be an insulin secretion. But then it's known that the oral glucose would cause more insulin secretion compared to intravenous glucose administered. Why is that? Because of this incremental effect or incretin effect. So IV glucose, intravenous glucose, it will enter the pancreas, or it will enter the pancreatic beta cells, and it will cause release of insulin directly. Whereas oral glucose will have a dual effect. Even oral glucose will enter the blood and it will cause direct release of insulin from the pancreatic beta cells, but it will have an additional effect. So oral glucose, it will directly, after entering the bloodstream, it will directly go to the pancreatic beta cell and will cause insulin secretion. However, additionally, oral glucose will, as it goes into the digestive tract, it will cause release of these incretins, these factors, from the GI mucosa. So, these incretins, they will also additionally cause insulin secretion from the pancreas. So this will be an additional effect, an incremental effect, for which reason this they were called as incretins. And therefore, remember, oral glucose causes more insulin secretion compared to intravenous glucose. It has this additional effect. Now, what are those incretins? The known incretins so far are these ones: GIP and GLP, GLP type 1. GIP, gastric inhibitory peptide, when it was discovered, it was named as gastric inhibitory peptide. But then later on, it was found that its role in the gastric inhibition, I mean inhibition of gastric acid secretion or inhibition of gastric movement, that role is not physiological. It works on the stomach in pharmacological doses. But this GIP is known to have this incretin effect, and therefore this peptide, which was previously called as gastric inhibitory peptide, is now called as glucose dependent insulinotropic peptide, or simply glucoinsulinotropic peptide. So in response to oral glucose, it is going to be released, this GIP is going to be released from the gut mucosa, and then it will cause insulin secretion from the pancreas, as we have seen here. So that's GIP, the one incretin known. The other one is glucagon like peptide, that's another known established incretin. And there are efforts to develop the drugs that are insulinotropic based on this known effect. So those drugs will be helpful in the treatment of diabetes. Those will be insulin secretagogues. So that's a short topic about the incretins and incretin effect.